Hey guys, it's your good friends, Patrick
and Jake.
And so, some of you might remember that over a year ago, in this very apartment, we wrote a screenplay in 3 days. Just 3 days. And in the past year, a lot of people have asked us what happened to that script.
We don't have a great answer.
No, well, people say, like, did you sell it? Are you gonna make it? And guys, no, because we wrote 120 pages in 3 days.
Yeah, so it's understandably a little bit of a mess.
It's a mess. It's like, it's not in a state where we would want to show anybody. Although that said,
we do have it right here.
We're showing it to you now. This is our 120 page script. The problem is though, since, you know, we're making videos every single week, and it's really tough to find time to work on these big other writing projects that don't have deadlines.
Right. The only deadlines that we ever had on this was our own self-imposed ones. And as soon as you get distracted with other day-to-day stuff, it becomes super easy to put this on the back burner.
Exactly.
So that's what happened.
And over the past year, we'll meet up occasionally, and we've gone through it and figured out what improvements we need to make for the next draft. Mm-hmm. And I realized that the only way, at least for me, to get these things done is to combine the big writing projects with the weekly videos.
Yep.
And so what we're going to do
is run the risk of potential public embarrassment again.
Yup.
Great.
In the next week, starting tomorrow, we are going to write draft number 2.
That's right. And to clarify another point, we have discussed what our game plan is going forward.
Yes.
And we have ideas of how to fix it. We're not going into this totally blind.
Yeah, we've gone through, we figured out all the changes, we have a whole new scene list, we know what scenes we're rewriting, we know what new scenes we're going to add, we've divided up in terms of who is going to write what scenes.
Yep.
And, but we're not going to do this in an enclosed apartment together, we're going to go off separately.
Yep, and each write our individual little scenes.
And so, you will follow our parallel journeys as we each attempt to write half of this script, but I think it's going to work. And once draft 2 is done, then we'll be able to show it to people and move this thing forward. But that's it. 7 days, we're gonna rewrite a 120 page script.
And hopefully we'll have something worth sharing this time.
And at the very least, we'll have a video.
Of us failing.
Yeah, and hopefully the video is not of us failing. Hopefully the video shows us succeeding.
Yeah.
But that's it. All right, starting tomorrow, we're writing a screenplay.
I tried to shoot the video scene where I'm walking to the cafe where I was writing, and I realized I hate doing that. I see a lot of people can just walk around with their phones and film themselves talking. I just think I have too much self-awareness of walking past other people and then having them look at me like I'm a psycho. So I have a little bit of a head start on Pat. I know Pat tends to think that I write relatively quickly, and maybe that's true. But don't jinx it, okay? And so in the past year, me and Pat have come up with all of the notes that we wanted to incorporate into this draft. And then, probably further down the line, once I've transcribed the notes that we have into every scene that I'm working on, and I've gotten a couple solutions for how to structure things, I'm probably gonna just do another read-through. And that's when I'm gonna focus on making sure that the dialogue doesn't sound stilted or weird. So sometimes you're stuck with this dilemma where you need the character maybe to deliver a line for a particular scene as exposition or something like that, but if you really thought about how that person would talk and how they would act in the situation that you're writing at, you're like, well, they wouldn't say any of this shit. Where do I find the balance between them saying what's needed for the story and them saying what's in character? Good luck, Pat. I hope you're doing well, too.
It's Wednesday night, the 4th of July. Right now, fireworks are happening all over the country, but not right where I am. See, I am out in the country, you know, kind of in the middle of nowhere, house sitting for my parents. They are out of town, and I thought I would come up here to an empty house to get some writing done. And also, I think I may have done some bad scheduling. The plan was to take the next week, starting today, Wednesday, through the next Tuesday, to write the second draft of the script, but I also did not finish the new videos in time, so I could have had a writing day today. I'm still editing, and I'm going to be editing tomorrow, so I really hope I finish this soon. Right now, it's 10 p.m., and I realize that I have not had dinner yet, so I'm making myself a pizza. It's time to cook and continue not writing. I spent the whole morning dealing with a computer issue. An update would not install for my operating system, and so the computer would not turn on, and I spent a while on the phone with Apple Tech Support. It all works now, thankfully. Problem solved, but I also lost the morning. Gonna keep editing. Gonna get to writing at some point. I bet Jake is really far ahead.
I had to work today, so it is currently 7:30, and I'm just getting started now. I'm gonna do what I usually like to do when I'm working after work, which is get a little bit of coffee in me. I'm gonna try and think a little bit more on Act Two, and hopefully we get some good work done tonight. I'm typically a morning person for this stuff, so I don't usually work as well later in the afternoon. We'll see.
Well, I have not finished editing the video, and I have not begun writing at all yet, but I'm still going to go leave the house now to see Ant-Man and the Wasp with my friend Amin. I've had no human interaction all day. I'm here with my friend Amin.
Hello!
We used to live together in the city, then he moved upstate to work in state politics. I mean, how's the world of state politics?
It's great! Everything's great! The MTA works!
Ant-Man and the Wasp, I thought it was a delight. You?
It was great!
And now we're drinking milkshakes.
Sponsored by Stewart's.
Sponsored by Stewart's, which anyone from the capital region of New York knows and loves. Obviously, I haven't finished editing the video, and I haven't started writing my half of the screenplay at all. I think I'll get it done by next Wednesday. Do you think I'll get it done by Wednesday?
Yeah, I've seen you do worse.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly, because, you know, if it really gets down to it, I just won't sleep. Feeling a little bit under the weather as well, which is great. I'm gonna try to finish this video up by like midday or so. Ah, this is exhausting.
I'm feeling like I'm at a pretty good pace, to be honest. It really helped that I had already done Act One. It's kind of tough finding some time to squeeze the writing in each day. I just did a little bit of writing on my lunch hour. I go to a spot that's nearby where I work.
Okay, the video is done. It's out. It's online. People are watching it. They seem to like it. Right now I'm gonna go outside and water the garden, as I've said to my parents that I would do. I'll just relax a bit and start thinking about the script, which I'm actually going to start writing now. Yay, only 2 days late. I'm realizing that I've been extremely tense all day, just anxious about getting this video done, and so it's slowly kind of being like let out now. I'm finally kind of relaxing.
Because I'm feeling potentially falsely confident about what I can get done tomorrow, I'm gonna try and read a little something that I think I can help get the creative juices flowing. There's definitely a better way to phrase that. I hate the phrase creative juices. It's just too, like, moist sounding. I am reading, currently, the graphic novel Black Hole by Charles Burns. I don't think this is giving too much away about the script that me and Pat are working on, but it involves characters in high school, and this is the same. Also with a little bit of a dark tone. So, we'll see. I mean, I could get nothing from this. I have no idea. Just figured I'd share something. Anyways, enjoy yourselves.
It's about 7 o'clock. I'm energized, people are digging the video, and I think I can get 10 pages done before I go to bed tonight. It's 1 in the morning, I did not get the writing done. Instead, I hung out with a friend for several hours. I got the editing done today. I'll get the writing done tomorrow. I will finish this. I don't even want to think about how much Jacob has surely gotten done by now. I'm sure I'm really letting the team down. About 4 days to write half a screenplay. Wow, I thought I was gonna have like a whole week this time. I did this to myself. Oh my god.
Hopefully I get a big chunk of the rest of Act Two done I'm planning on finishing it tomorrow.
Oh, I'm starting to get actually stressed now. I was so concerned just about finishing the video. This, like, was not at the forefront of my mind, but now it is, and it's real. And I've really got to get a lot of work done. Opening scene is done. We're making progress. On to the next scene.
I'm 10 pages in. 10 pages done in the script. Only about 50 more to go. My lift is on its way here. I'm leaving the house to head back to the city. I'm gonna write on the train. I'm gonna try to get another 10 pages done before I arrive in New York. Back in the city, it's midnight, someone's shooting off fireworks outside. I don't know why the 4th of July was days ago, but on the train, I finished rewriting my half of Act 1. Tomorrow, on to Act 2. This is gonna work. I'm gonna get the work done. I can do it. I also tomorrow have to watch a movie and record a podcast, but it's gonna work. Okay, so I have finished watching yet another Josh Hartnett film because we have to record a podcast tonight that will be released the following night. So now that's done, the movie was actually also pretty okay, which doesn't happen that often. It's not quite noon yet, so I've got 6 or so hours to get some writing done. Can I get 30 pages written? No, that's not gonna happen.
I have written 3 of the 10 scenes I have to write for Act 2. It's going slowly.
Right now, I'm at Jake's apartment because we're about to record a new episode of our podcast. Jake, how are you doing in your writing, in your week of writing?
I'm good.
How far ahead are you?
I've finished everything I need to do for Acts 1 and 2.
How many? You had a head start. You had written stuff already.
Right.
Like going into this. How much have you written all your Act 1 stuff already?
Yeah, so I had already written everything from Act 1 that we talked about.
Yeah, it's coming along.
Well, the thing is, I was saying too, I had like a little bit of this head start too, and it's still been kind of difficult for me as well, you know?
Right.
And not that I want to complain or anything.
Okay. We've got a Josh Hartnett film to talk about, so.
Oh, yeah.
Finish this scene. Going to bed now. So I decided to spend the night at Jake's because I was really tired and I wanted to get some work done and it would have taken an hour to get home. So I did that. It's next morning, I'm on the roof right now, and I'm gonna head out and get some breakfast and then write all day. I'm back home. I've gotten more writing done. It's like 2 p.m. right now. What I'm doing right now, that's been working pretty well, is I'm not forcing myself to absolutely go scene by scene. I'm writing whatever part is coming to me the quickest, whatever part I feel like I understand and know the best, because I figure there's no point in wasting time in just, you know, sitting there agonizing over one scene when you could be just be writing a later scene that you're not gonna be struggling with. Like the scene I'm writing right now, I'm still a little stuck on how to enter the scene, like the first half of it, but I immediately figured out the dialogue I want for the second half of the scene, some of the key stuff and the key beats and exchanges that I want in there, and so I just jumped ahead, wrote that, I'll come back. We're back at Jake's again. It is Monday night. It's already about 8:30, and we are going to try to rewrite as much of Act 3 as possible. There's Jake. And I feel like Act 3 needs the least work of all of the acts,
no,
right?
No, it needs the least work, and it's the most fun one to write.
It's the most fun, it's the most linear, and the shortest.
Exactly, it's like 20 pages, if that.
We can do this.
Oh yeah. He's gonna do something that maybe hurts somebody else, or other.
Or like, kind of the centerpiece of a lot of the, like, he's
down as they research like that.
Right.
Something that's like, could be catastrophic, and
so right now, it is 11:45 p.m. We did not finish
Act 3.
Act 3, we really didn't. I'm once again gonna crash at Jake's place. And yeah, and then tomorrow during the day, I'm going to finish up Act 2, and then in the evening, we're gonna finish up Act 3, mm-hmm. and then down to the wire, but we're gonna do it.
Yeah, we will make our Wednesday date.
Okay, I'm back from Jake's, where I once again spent the night. Yeah, I put on the same clothes in the morning. Feel gross, also have been just holding off getting sick for many days now because I am pushing myself too hard and not getting enough sleep, and it's great, and now I have to finish editing this week's episode of the podcast because it should be up by now. Everything is going great. Also, I haven't eaten breakfast yet. I'm gonna do that now while editing. I'm so tired. Another scene for Act 2 done. Great, that just leaves four scenes for Act 2, and a lot of my Act 3 stuff is honestly just kind of staying the same from Draft 1. I've got to make up a bunch of stuff now. This is one of the big set pieces, the big sort of like suspenseful horror set pieces for Act 2. Actually, it's like two set pieces, kind of like intercutting, one in a creepy house, one with a big death. Hey. Doing the usual.
Uh-oh.
Furious to try to finish the screenplay. So it's getting close to midnight, and I still have a bunch of writing to do, although it's going quickly now. I have a good pace, so I've made a pot of tea, drinking it out of the MODOK mug, and this, fingers crossed, will sustain me to the finish line. Okay, I'm going to bed. I have to do a bit of polishing of like the last 10 pages in the morning, but I'm like, I can't stay conscious, I can't think anymore. I'm like, practically there. I feel terrible. My throat hurts physically. I don't feel good. And I know this is because I have just worked too hard and too much. I didn't 100% finish last night. I got most of it done. Basically, I need to kind of polish the last 10 pages a little bit. I've got to get this done because then I can relax and I can just not do stuff anymore and just like take a break and recover. Everything hurts. I'm not even exercising. Okay. I think we're done. 67 pages written in 5 days. That's not 67 pages written from scratch like we did with the first draft. A bunch of stretches of this are like lightly modified from the original draft. We're gonna have to meet up one more time, smooth it all over, get it a bit more polished, and then the part that I've been most excited about, once we feel like we've got a solid enough draft and we've done most of the work, we can get a bunch of friends together and we'll do a table read. We will have everyone read this thing out loud together so we can hear what it sounds like, we can get their feedback. They'll probably all tell us that it's a bunch of incomprehensible garbage and it makes no sense, but whatever. This is important. We are moving forward on this thing. It's been so long. I know so many of you ask regularly, like, what happened with that thing? Guys, screenplays are hard. They take a long time to like to come together, especially when you're trying to crank out like a video every single week. But despite the fact that I feel like utter garbage right now, I feel good about the work that we did. I'm proud of us. We finally accomplished this thing that we've been talking about for so long, and now I'm going to just collapse on the couch and cue victorious music playing over this shot.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Okay.
Matt actually finished before me. He just sent me a text earlier today. He said that he was up until 2 a.m. last night. So technically, it did take him until Wednesday, the final day. But that he also felt like a trash person for having stayed up that late and edited two other videos. So, Pat, I gotta hand it to you. I had the head start, and you still managed to beat me. I actually got distracted yesterday, so I didn't get quite as much writing as I thought I would done, which means I gotta throw in the last little bit that I need to do for Act 3. That needs to happen right now. So I'm doing something that I don't usually like to do because it fucks with my day the next day. If I stay up too late, I don't know. I'm cranky. Maybe I'm too lame. I should probably just be able to stay up sometimes when I want to. But it's sponsored by Red Bull. So I'm going to drink that, and it usually does the trick. And I should be able to get this done in the week that we set out for ourselves. So wish me luck. We got this bad boy right here. Look at that script. You can't look at any of the dialogue, though, because don't steal my beautiful lines. All right. I finished, and it is currently, time on the clock is 11:29 p.m. So I managed to get the last couple of pages that I needed done. And that's it. That's all of Act 3. Half an hour under the gun before our week-long challenge had finished. So even though it still felt like a little bit of a rush as we were doing it, I still think we're gonna come away with a script that's a lot better. I'm just really tired. So I don't feel like a trash person though. So Pat, that's uniquely you. All of our draft number two is finished, and we forced ourselves to do it in a week. So there.